Hey friend, Brandon here. After talking about the existence of this device back in September of 2018 and leaking out the prices for the device early, the Google Pixel 3a and 3a XL is finally here. And let's be honest, it wasn't made for you. Okay, it was probably made for a few of you, but it isn't for most of you. Let me explain, because this is Tech Today. Please share, subscribe, and hit the bell icon to be notified of when I post a new video. I'd really appreciate it. By now, you've probably seen, heard, or read about the announcement of the Google Pixel 3a or the 3a XL. By the way, what do you think the A stands for? Maybe it's for the Pixel 3... Ah, crap, the Pixel 3 XL didn't sell well. That's stupid. Anyways, leave your guesses below. An idiot. The Google Pixel 3a and 3a XL are new mid-range devices from Google, a well-known brand with an amazing camera that is as good, if not better, than other flagship phones. It has awesome Google Pixel software features like call screening, the Google Assistant, always-on display on an OLED display, the headphone jack, yes, stereo speakers, unlimited photo storage, and quick software updates for 3 years, and it's at an insane price starting at $399. Google is aiming for what I'm going to coin now as the delight to dollar ratio. And the Pixel 3a has a really high delight to dollar ratio. And yet, many of you still hate this phone. You find it a bit of a ripoff or a terrible buy. If that's you, then this phone wasn't made for you. In fact, Google probably didn't even have you in mind or consider you when designing, making, or marketing this phone. You see, there are a number of people who said the phone was a failure even before knowing the specs or the price, and that's just crazy. Once it was announced, I heard over and over again that you can get a OnePlus 7, a OnePlus 6, a Samsung Galaxy S8, or this or that for the same price. So let me show you this diagram that's out there that I've seen in productions, but also applies to other industries, where it shows you a diagram of good, fast, and cheap, and how you can only pick two. You can't have it all. Of course, this isn't a direct translation, but you get what I'm trying to say. Do you want this phone to be of the highest quality materials? Do you want it to have the best and fastest specs? Do you want it to be cheap? Well, you can only have two of those. You can't have it all. To ask for the phone to be $100 less, but also have the brand new and fastest UFS 3.0 storage, which the average consumer doesn't even know about, and to have it with a flagship processor and made out of metal and glass, is probably the most illogical and ridiculous thing to ask for. You can't have it all. You can't have all the specs and a cheap price. And here's the thing, Google doesn't care about specs. And honestly, none of it really matters. None of it will matter. This phone wasn't made for you, and it will sell well. It will probably be one of Google's best-selling phones, if not their best-selling phone ever to date. When I say Google doesn't really care about specs and you don't believe me, well, don't look to me. Look at what Google actually did. Look at their actions. You see, Google didn't even talk about the specs that much at all during the announcement, because specs don't matter. I know some of you will say it's because Google is embarrassed by the specs, but that's ridiculous. No, they're not embarrassed. They know it doesn't matter. And this is probably one of the most confident things I've ever seen Google do. They know this will sell really well to people that are probably not you. Look at what they did. They focus on the things that matter the most to normal people. The screen is a solid OLED screen, which is something you don't often see in a phone at this price point. Honestly, you usually see a bad screen and an LCD screen at that, and this one is actually better than the OLED screen on the normal Pixel 3. It just looks better, it's calibrated better, and it doesn't have a ton of black smear on it, like even a Galaxy S10 Plus screen has. Yeah, I'm serious. I mean, you've probably seen those cheap screens where you can just press down on it and it flexes and it feels like you're just gonna break it. It's plastic, right? It's not even glass. And if you think about it, it makes sense that you would have a high quality screen on your phone. It's what you look at all the time. And then while the speakers are not front facing, they're still stereo speakers and they sound great and are plenty loud. Honestly, they're really clear, but aren't as full as the Pixel 3, the normal one. But that's not a big deal. And it also has a headphone jack. They didn't really talk about specs beyond that. Instead, they focused on how the phone itself can make your life better. They pointed out night sight.
What other smartphone cameras try to do with expensive hardware, we can deliver with software and AI, including high-end computational photography. So here's what that means. Pixel 3a can take amazing photos in low light with night sight.
portrait mode and SuperRes zoom for the camera. They pointed out call screening and the other benefits of the Google Assistant on a Pixel device. And they pointed out the benefits of augmented reality when using Google Maps to navigate around. They pointed out that there's 3 years of security and software updates. Do you see what they're doing? They kept the main things the main things. But don't just look at their announcement. If you really want to know who they're targeting, look at what their advertising is saying. Want a great camera that takes pictures as good or better than the flagships? Check. Want unlimited photo and video storage for free? Check. Want all-day battery and fast charging? Check. Want a headphone jack? Check.
Because we've heard some people want more headphone options.
Want awesome Google Assistant features? Check. Want it for less than half the cost of a flagship?
For real?
Check. It's the Pixel 3 affordable. These are all the things that affect how a person feels and uses the phone. Specs don't matter. This phone is for the masses, for the people who don't care about specs, which is the majority of people. It's for the price conscious, for the dads, and for the moms. Literally, when a mom walks into a store, they could see the Apple iPhone XS or the Galaxy S10, see the price of $1,000, and they have to question whether or not they should buy it because it's so expensive. And then, out of the corner of their eye, they see a phone for sale for $399 from who? Oh, Google. I know that name. Oh, it has a great camera too. Oh, look at how soft and smooth it looks and feels. Oh, that purplish color is so cute. And then they see the price again, $399. And you know what they say? Yeah, I can do that. Boom, easy sale. In America, a mom, the everyday person, won't know what a Xiaomi or Redmi phone is. They just want a phone from a company they are familiar with that feels great, that looks great, that works great, and improves their lives. They just use it, and if it works well and it's nice, then they'll love it. And I've been using it for the past few days, and I'm absolutely delighted by it. In many ways, it's as good or better than the Pixel 3. So when I'm using it, I keep thinking, how in the world is this only $400? Sure, it doesn't have a glass back with a metal frame or wireless charging or a wide-angle selfie camera, but is that worth $400 more? Heck no. If that bugs you enough that it doesn't have it, then this phone isn't for you. If you want that, go spend the money for it. The reality is that this thing runs just as good as a Pixel 3 if you just use the dang thing and enjoy it like most people would. And on top of that, the screen is of a higher quality than the normal 3.
You can see it by looking at its dynamic range or how many squares you can see here. But the biggest difference is the amount of black smear or that jelly black ghosting bleed over from the black to the gray square when scrolling.
And it's a little bit bigger to make typing easier without being huge. I honestly can't think of a reason why I can suggest a normal 3 to people, but I can think of a ton for the Pixel 3a. You see, the delight to dollar ratio on the Pixel 3a is off the charts, and it's totally catered to the moms, to the everyday people, and for the budget conscious. They even have some crazy deals like $100 back in gift cards, or even additional items added onto it depending on where you buy it from. You see, deals like that are huge for me, and I hate purchasing anything without making sure I have the best deal possible, which is why I want to talk to you about a free browser plugin that saves you money and gives you rewards on your normal purchases from this video sponsor, Swagbucks. Honestly, with life getting busier and busier for me, I don't want to spend time looking for and testing out coupon codes. Swagbucks has proven to be super helpful for me. It's a simple and free browser plugin that kicks in during the normal checkout process and searches for and applies coupon codes for you to save you money and earn cash back on your purchases for a ton of online retailers. Being the skeptical type, I investigated Swagbucks and found out that they're legit with 4 stars, and they have given out over $300 million in cash back through PayPal or Amazon gift cards. So why is it free? What's the catch? They simply make their money through affiliate income from your normal purchases and then pass on their earnings onto you while also finding you the best deals possible. It's a win-win, and I love finding great value and tools to help you out. So click the link below in the description to add the swag button to your browser for free, and you'll get a $10 bonus when you make your first purchase with the swag button. So what do you think? Are you getting the Pixel 3a or 3a XL? Was this made for you or for a parent or the normal person who doesn't even know what a multi-core is? Leave a comment below and join the This Is Tech Today community Discord chat. There's a link down below in the description. And of course, leave more guesses for what the A stands for. I really want to hear them, and we can be super cheesy and cringy together. Sorry, but not sorry. Thank you for watching This Is Tech Today, where we talk about the intersection of technology in our everyday lives, in business, and in all things creative. Until next time.